Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 15th of October. Heavy rainfall causes flood-like situation in India's Maharashtra and Karnataka. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan rules out reconciliation with opposition. And idol makers in Nepal stared at gloomy festival season amid pandemic. And now for all the details. Flood-like situations occurred in parts of India's western Maharashtra and southern Karnataka states on Thursday following heavy rainfall. The National Disaster Response Force initiated various rescue operations in the affected areas of the two states. This came a day after at least 30 people were killed in rain-related incidents in southern Telangana and Andhra Pradesh states.
Heavy rainfall caused flood-like situations in parts of India's western Maharashtra and southern Karnataka on Thursday, prompting disaster management forces to swing into action and launch rescue and relief operations in both the states. People in Baramati in Maharashtra's Pune district had to come out of their homes as rainwater inundated residential areas and submerged vehicles. Three people reportedly lost their lives near dawn in Pune due to overflowing of a canal in the area. Furthermore, over 2 lakh cubics of water had to be discharged from the Sona barrage into the Bhima River in Karnataka state as the incessant rainfall led to a rise in the water level of the barrage and submerged a nearby bridge.
Under the influence of the system, coastal Karnataka is very likely to experience widespread rainfall on 15th October, fairly widespread rainfall on 16th October and scattered rainfall on 17th, 18th and 19th October.
Meanwhile, India's junior interior minister G. Kishan Reddy reviewed situation in flooded areas in Telangana's Hyderabad city, a day after heavy rainfall lashed the southern Indian state and neighbouring Andhra Pradesh, killing at least 30 people. Many parts of Hyderabad had received more than 25 centimetres of rainfall over the past 24 hours, while flood water inundated main roads and caused widespread chaos. Authorities in Hyderabad declared a holiday on Wednesday and Thursday and asked residents to stay indoors.
Making the coronavirus protocols the new normal, multiplexes, cinema halls and theatres were allowed to reopen in parts of India on Thursday with precautionary measures. The reopening as part of Unlock 5 comes amid rapid rise in coronavirus cases.
Government of India allowed multiplexes, cinema halls and theatres to reopen across the country after around 7 months of coronavirus closure from Thursday within the framework of a set of standard operating procedures or SOPs. However, the Interior Ministry left it to states to take the final call on the reopening. While theatres and multiplexes will remain closed in worst affected states due to the virus like Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Chhattisgarh. They opened in northern Uttar Pradesh and is expected to open in several other places this week, including Indian capital New Delhi.
देखिए जैसा कि सामान्य दर्शकों के लिए सामान्य प्रोटोकॉल जो आया हुआ है, जिसमें सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग की 6 फीट का पालन करना है, उसके अलावा सिनेमा में एंट्री के लिए मास्क निहायत ही आवश्यक है, बगैर मास्क के एंट्री सिनेमा में नहीं मिलेगी, और सार्वजनिक स्थल पे थूकने पे प्रतिबंध रहेगा।
और कोरोना के बाद ये टाइम बड़ा ही अच्छा लग रहा है कि हम फिर से शुरुआत एक नई शुरुआत कर पा रहे हैं एक नए नॉर्मल के साथ।
Many cinema halls across India were closed even before the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced the nationwide lockdown to curb the coronavirus spread in March. India is in its unlock 5.0 after the lockdown, but has so far recorded 812,390 confirmed cases of COVID-19, including 111,266 deaths. Yet the country's recovery rate continues to rise and now stands at 87.4%.
In news from Pakistan, as opposition parties under the banner of their newly formed alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement will be holding its first power show against the government on Friday, Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan has ruled out reconciliation with them.
Standing his ground despite opposition parties threatening to oust his government, Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan on Wednesday said that there will be no reconciliation with the opposition. Addressing a meeting of government spokesperson where he criticized opposition parties, Imran said the only reason opposition parties were being allowed to hold rallies was so they cannot later use the political revenge card against the government. Opposition parties under the banner of their newly formed alliance PDM, Pakistan Democratic Movement, aim to oust Prime Minister Imran Khan's government. PDM is scheduled to hold its first public rally in Gujranwala on October 16, followed by several cities including Karachi, Peshawar, Multan and Lahore. Meanwhile, ahead of the first rally in Pakistan, the leader of Jamiat Ulema Islam Fazl and Pakistan Democratic Movement Maulana Fazlur Rahman has warned the Imran Khan-led incumbent government that it won't see December. These statements come on the back of Monday's remarks by Pakistani Muslim League Nawaz Vice President Maryam Nawaz, who said that Prime Minister Imran Khan government would go home before January.
Moving on, protests have continued against Pakistan's illegally occupied territories against Islamabad's attempts to alter the legal status of Gilgit-Baltistan. There is also resentment over plan to hold elections in Gilgit-Baltistan in November.
Political activists in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have opposed Pakistan's plan to alter the status of Gilgit-Baltistan and turn the illegally occupied region into its fifth province. Protests have continued across Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan, expressing anger against the arbitrary decision in violation of UN resolutions and the denial of fundamental rights to the common public. There is also resentment over Islamabad's plan to hold elections to the so-called Gilgit-Baltistan Legislative Assembly on November 15.
वक्त नहीं है हमारे पास ये तो इंतखाबात तक तो ये तो अपोजिशन की गुजारिश पे इंतखाबात तक लेट हुआ जो जीबी के इलेक्शन है इन्होंने तो चीजें फाइनलाइज की हुई हैं तो हम ये समझते हैं कि ये आगे 3-4 महीने हमें रोडों पे रहना पड़ेगा.
India has also launched a strong protest against the Pakistan government, stating that Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, including Gilgit-Baltistan, are an integral part of India. Activists have expressed concern that China has been lobbying Pakistan to bring the illegally occupied region under its legal jurisdiction to protect its investments in Gilgit-Baltistan, which are part of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC.
In news from Afghanistan, a general meeting of Afghan government and the Taliban negotiators in Doha on Wednesday evening discussed resolving the disputed issues as soon as possible. The two sides have so far failed to reach consensus on procedural rules for the direct talks.
A general meeting of chiefs and delegates from both the Afghan government and the Taliban was held on Wednesday evening in Doha, said Nader Nadri, a member of the Afghan government's negotiating team. In a tweet, Nadri informed the issue of resolving the disputed issues was discussed in the meeting and it was emphasized that the contact groups from both the sides should provide solutions as soon as possible. Taliban spokesperson in Doha, Mohammad Naeem, also confirmed that contested points were discussed and agenda will be discussed next. The two sides have so far failed to reach consensus on religious basis for the talks and connection of the US-Taliban deal with the negotiations. Meanwhile, amid efforts for peace, clashes between Afghan government forces and the Taliban in Helmand province have entered their fifth day, resulting in several casualties. In the latest development, at least 9 people were killed when 2 Mi-17 helicopters of Afghan National Army crashed in Helmand's Nawa district on Wednesday.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka.
A Sri Lankan court has fined the Greek captain of the Fire Strike an empty new diamond supertanker $65,000 after he pleaded guilty to the charges. Colombo High Court judge ordered the captain is released after paying the fine.
The captain of empty new diamond supertanker, which caught fire off Sri Lanka with a cargo of 2 million barrels of oil, was fined 20 million Sri Lankan rupees, that is $65,000 on Wednesday. Captain Istiros Ilias, a Greek national, faced charges of negligence and pollution after the tanker caught fire following a blast in its engine room in early September. The ship, loaded with 2 million barrels of Kuwaiti oil, left two long trails of fuel oil. The owners of the new diamond have agreed to pay $2.27 million to Sri Lanka for its help in extinguishing the blaze and averting disaster. Navy spokesman Captain Indica de Silva said that it would take between 1.5 to 2 months for the ship to make its way to its final destination of Fujairah, United Arab Emirates, in its present state. He said the supertanker, which has been towed, is currently in Maldivian waters.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Idol makers in Nepal who often make good profit ahead of annual festivals are disappointed with less buyers this year amid the coronavirus pandemic. There are many festivals in Nepal during which people worship idols of gods with great fervor. But this time, several restrictions are in place to avoid a further spread of infection, thus muting grand celebrations.
Idol makers in Nepal are disappointed as they are having very low sales with less buyers of idols ahead of various annual festivals amid the coronavirus threat. There are various festivals in Nepal during which people worship idols of gods with great fervor. However, this year, with the pandemic, there are several restrictions in place regarding gathering of people during festivals to avoid a further spread of the infection. Thus, the demand for idols has reduced, leaving the artisans with almost no work.
Set hoina set ta yo Durga ko jamma 3-4 set jancha ani Bishwakarma ko jancha 6 wata jati. E yo barsha ma ta gayena. Yo barsha ma chapat cha byapar. Yo espali 2 set Durga gayo teti ho. Gako chaina.
As of Thursday morning, Nepal had 117,996 confirmed coronavirus cases with death toll of 675.
Pulwama district in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir has been in the news for being the terror hotbed. It may bring memories of the terror attack on paramilitary CRPF convoy in February, but this district might soon be known as the Pencil Slate District of India. All major companies of pencil making units in the country procure their slates from Pulwama.
Pulwama, which has been in the news for being the terror hotbed in India's Jammu and Kashmir, might soon be known as the Pencil Slate District of India. Pulwama is making pencils of soft slate, and now 90% of the raw material supply will be sourced from 17 units set up in the district. All major companies of pencil making units in the country procure the slates from Pulwama. Manzoor Ahmed Ilahi, who has been in the business since 2010 and among the first to start a business in Kashmir, said poplar wood is used for making the slate and it grows in abundance in Kashmir.
यहाँ पेंसिल की raw material factory डाली है हमारे यहाँ कम से कम 100 से लेकर 150 तक मजदूर काम कर रहे हैं जिनमें कश्मीरियों के साथ साथ बाहर के भी मजदूर काम कर रहे हैं हम जो ये माल बनाते हैं बाहर जो बाहर रियासतों में पेंसिल बना के काम आता है
These units are thriving in almost every household but the pandemic has hit the industry hard A local resident working at one of the factories said The government should support these units so that more youths are engaged in this sector and are employed.
मैं अपने जो मालिक है यहाँ उसका नाम है मंजूर अहमद उन्होंने ये यहाँ फैक्ट्री खोली है इसके वजह से मुझे भी एक रोजगार मिल गया मैं भी फार्म वार्म नहीं के पीछे नहीं पड़ गया मैंने भी अपने रोजगार का इंतजाम यहाँ ही किया है मगर मैं अब ये चाहता हूँ जो हमारे स्लेट यहाँ से बनता है इसकी मेरा मतलब है इसकी डेवलपमेंट होनी चाहिए
Slate manufacturing industry is providing jobs to youth and quietly contributing to the region's economy in a small way.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.